What's up, Knights? It's been a long couple of months, but we're so glad to be back and rolling. On today's episode, we check out Isaac Matter's pretty sick skating skills, discover a vintage arcade in Mesa, and explore a small nail business owned and operated by Higley Sr. Stay tuned because an all-new episode starts right now. Good morning, Knights. I'm Maya Griffin. Kaylee Sotelo is a young entrepreneur who runs a successful nail business out of her home. She provides a variety of different nail styles and techniques for her clients, along with seasonal designs and nails for every occasion. She also happens to be a Higley Knight and a dedicated student. Mikayla and Sophia recently visited her home-based salon to find out more about her flourishing business.
Kaylee Sotelo is a student here at Higley who happens to have her own thriving nail business. Kaylee is extremely talented when it comes to her craft, while her small business is consistently growing.
I came up with the idea of my nail business because I love getting my nails done, and I just could never find what I wanted at local nail salon shops. I did take a certification class so I could get certified. I am currently looking into going to a nail school specifically just for nails so I could get my license. I have a wide range of clientele, as young as 14 that come and get their nails done, and as old as grandmas that just want to get pampered. And that's what I love. I love meeting new people every day. Some different nails that I do for events are quinceañeras, weddings, birthday nails, Halloween, fall, Christmas, all types. I love almost every single set that I do. Every day it's something exciting and creative and new. And I love that my clients always challenge me to do better than I did yesterday. The most rewarding thing about having my small business, especially in the field that I'm in, is when I'm done with the set and a girl comes in, you know, feeling a little bit low. And once I'm done, she just looks at herself, looks down, and she just feels so good.
While there are many other nail salons available, we were curious to ask her why she believes people should get their nails done by her instead of a regular technician.
A small business owner will really take their time. They will use good products, legal products. They will give you exactly what you want. You feel more comfortable communicating with them. Like, if you don't like something, you can tell them. That's why I believe, because you could really get exactly what you're looking for. You guys should visit my Instagram page and schedule an appointment with me at Slate by K. I would love to service you guys and give you exactly what you're looking for, the perfect Instagram nails.
Nice. If you are ever in need for nails, be sure to support local small businesses and hit up Kaylee Sotelo.
Reporting for the studio, it's Mikayla
and Sophia.
Hey Knights, I'm Mikayla Jones and I'm super excited to be back. This week, Best Buddies Pure Associates handed out bags announcing the first lunch party of the year. All Best Buddies members, be sure to head to the amphitheater on October 21st during your lunch and dress Hawaiian. Starfighters Arcade is a retro video game arcade located in Mesa. It's filled with pinball machines and vintage-style video game cabinets that look like a scene straight out of Stranger Things. Maddie and Drake recently stopped in to learn more about this Higley hotspot.
Starfighters Arcade is located in Mesa and features many vintage games. They have over 115 video game cabinets and over 45 pinball machines. Mike Lovato, the co-owner, tells us how his arcade is different from others.
I believe that our arcade here is different from others because we provide entertainment for all ages and we welcome families and friends, whereas most other arcades, you might see a mix between a bar and an arcade, and it isn't all ages. Here, we're all ages, and we welcome everyone, really.
The arcade came to be through Mike's early childhood experiences.
My family and I, we moved into our house. There was a basement level, and I had the idea that this would be a very cool entertainment room. So I bought a multicade, and ever since then, I started tinkering around with stuff, and it really built an interest for collecting games. I think it really started with that one cabinet, and just wanting more games from there. Collectors around the valley also have their games here, and we sort of rent it out for them here. So some of the games are also just from other collectors around the valley.
Starfighters Arcade is open to the public from 7 p.m. to 11 p.m. Friday and Saturday, and from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. on Sunday. Visit their website at starfightersarcade.com for more information. This is Maddie and Drake signing off for The Studio.
Girls volleyball is back in session. This past Tuesday, our Lady Knights dominated the Blackhawks. Freshmen won both sets, JV took 2 out of 3 sets, and varsity swept Williamsfield, winning all 3 sets. Great job, Knights.
Knights, be sure to bring money for everyone's favorite day of the month, Food Truck Friday on October 30th.
Through the stress of trying to figure out how to complete the FAFSA and Common App, college application season can be an exhausting experience. Luckily, I sat down with Mrs. Novak, the new college and career counselor, to help us work through the process.
As college application deadlines approach, there is an overwhelming sense of stress building within many seniors. Mrs. Novak and I work together to show how easy it is to apply to your desired colleges.
So for a senior to apply to college, you're going to find out the school that you want to go to first and foremost. Once you've identified that school, then you'll go to their website to look at the application and the admission process.
Mrs. Novak explains how college applications can be accessed and completed through our district website.
So you go to husd.org, you'll go over to departments. Once you go to departments, then you're going to go ahead and click on career and technical education. Once you've clicked on career and technical education, you're going to go ahead and click on CTE one more time. Once you've clicked on CTE, you're going to scroll down, you're going to identify the school, Higley High School, and then click on College and Career Center. Once you've clicked on College and Career Center, we've got a number of different things out here. In addition to all of our news and announcements, you can go to the college application process. There's scholarships out here. And most specifically, we just finished with a career and college fair, and we've done recordings for not only in-state, out-of-state, but also alternative options as well. So if you do go to that area where it says college and career fair recordings, you'll find recording links in addition to contact information for over 50 schools around not only the Arizona area, but the Southwest area as well.
Well, Knights, now that you know how to apply to the college of your choice, make sure to get your applications turned in before their due dates. Reporting for The Studio, I'm Maya Griffin.
Girls soccer is having preseason practices to get ready for tryouts in the upcoming season every Tuesday and Thursday from 2:45 to 4 p.m. on the practice field until November 5th, so come out and join us and let a friend know. Also, make sure you get Register My Athlete completed and turned in no later than November 6th so you can join us for tryouts.
This past February, Higley unfortunately lost someone who was a friend to all. After the passing of Luke Knight, some of his closest friends have come together to honor him with a band named Luca. Ethan Nuttall got with the boys to find out more.
Four Higley seniors have been working hard to create signature sound for their new band, Luca. I learned more about why they decided to start this band and the special meaning behind it.
Band Luca started just because we all play an instrument and we all just wanted to get together and create and just make some rad music.
We have a friend that died 8 months ago and we just wanted to make something for him because he wanted my friend Chanson to start a band, and so that's what we're doing.
We just thought it would be cool to sort of make songs that kind of represented how our friend group is and, you know, the way we do things and sort of just, you know, how to live life and kind of stuff like that.
The brotherly relationship they share plays an important role in creating the music they love.
Dude, our relationship, I think it's like super strong. Like, these are like one of my best friends I've ever had in my life, and it's just that I get to like have something with my best friends, and then we get to create something and have like a ton of fun together, and like, it's so sick.
All four found their passion for music at a very young age and find inspiration in many popular bands.
Growing up, we had a guitar in our house, and I had seen it, and I wanted to play it so bad, but I never really got into a lesson, so I just taught myself and went from there.
I found my love for music by my dad having a band in high school, and he made a ton of songs with his friends, and that's what I want to do.
I really look up to like Blink-182. Like their riffs are just killer. Most of my riffs come from their basic tempo and their basic beats and stuff like that. And I also look up to like Neck Deep and their like lyricism and Jimmy Eat World and things like that. Like just real deep meaning to songs, but like they put it in a cool way.
As they work to complete the first few songs of their own, they have set several goals along the way.
We're really just doing it for fun. It's pretty mellow. We're not trying to really take it anywhere, but I don't know, we'll just see how it goes.
I just really just want to have fun. Like, I just really want to have fun. I want people to have fun with me, and I want people to enjoy like our music and the things that we want to write and the things that we want to talk about in our lyrics.
Luca plans on dropping music in the next couple of months and hope to share it with you all. Reporting for the studio, I'm Ethan Nuttall.
Just prior to spring break, the Higley High School annual Club Rush was held in the courtyard. Students looking to get involved in extracurricular activities had the chance to learn about the various clubs and athletic programs available on campus. If you are still interested in joining a club, see Mrs. Davis in the bookstore for a list of active clubs and advisors. The new Media Center is definitely going to be a hot spot for students this upcoming year. With the new renovations and a new cafe, Hayden and Nathan decided to go check it out and see what it's all about.
Over the years, Higley has made changes to the campus, such as new paint, a new football field, as well as new carpets in most buildings. Along with these changes, Higley has decided to change the Media Center into a new student union. Administration saw that libraries are outdated and the school needed to be more future-proof.
We're really updating the Media Center to be more in tune with the times of current reality. A lot of kids don't check out books or spend time in libraries anymore. We're heading more in the direction of a student union type building. There'll be food in there, there'll be electronics in there, there'll be a variety of charging stations and different seating arrangements where it'll be a more inviting place for kids.
From what I've seen, they're making a lot of different improvements to the Media Center. They've got the cool new snack bar in there that's got coffee and all sorts of other good offerings in there for snacks and refreshments throughout the day. It looks like it's going to have a lot of good spaces for students to gather, to work on homework, just to kind of hang out and have a place that's really theirs on campus.
I mean, it'll be a place where people can just hang out and chill. It's just a relaxing place, you know?
And somewhere that you can get together. I think you're allowed to eat in there, do some homework, catch up on certain stuff.
With this remodel, the student union has a lot to offer and provides more opportunities for students.
We're going to have TV monitors in there, streaming video. We're going to have collaboration stations where there's a video device on the wall. Students can cast and collaborate on documents or presentations. Also, the esports group will have a place to practice as well as host events and have spectators watch the event. We'll be able to cast that up on the media wall while the students are in the quality computers high enough for the gaming that they're participating in to hold their events there.
I think the changes that they're making to the Media Center are positive. Obviously, it's strange to not have a library where students can go check out books on campus. But I think overall the changes are very positive because it really is. It's nice to have that additional snack bar / coffee shop option. And it really looks super nice in there from what I've seen. It looks like it's just a nice gathering place for students.
As we look forward to the completion of the student union, we also look forward to the changes to the campus in the future. Reporting for the studio, this is Nate Kinsey and Hayden Ashton.
DECA is hosting a shoe drive. Please bring new or gently used shoes to room 774. This fundraiser supports Higley's DECA chapter and small businesses in third world countries.
The football game tonight is senior night. Tickets are on sale now at gofan.co. While they are only $3 plus a service fee, right now only students can purchase the tickets and the general public will be able to purchase them tomorrow. So get them while you can.
With outdoor activities recently becoming more accessible and the fall weather settling in, skating has become very popular among high school students. But Isaac Matter is nowhere near new to the activity. Ryan and Lacey headed to the skate park to catch up with Isaac and find out more about his sick tricks.
Isaac Matter is a Higley High School senior who loves to skateboard in his free time. We caught up with Isaac and asked him a couple questions.
I've been skating for around like, I don't know, 6 years, 5 to 6 years on and off. I started skating because I was really bad at any sport with the ball. and my brother and friends kind of got into it, so I naturally followed them and just been skating ever since.
Pro skaters are a big inspiration for Isaac, but his biggest inspiration is a little closer to him.
Who inspires me or my role model is my older brother. He got me into it, and then just all my friends just fun to skate together, and then there's pros that are always fun to watch, and yeah, those definitely get you hyped up when you see a really good skater.
Getting hurt is 75% of skating, but some injuries hurt a little more than others.
The time I've gotten hurt is when I've gotten popsicled, and if you don't know what that means, it means like when the board shoots up in between your legs and you land on it, and that hurts. But yeah, it's only happened once, so.
Skating is a big sacrifice of your time, energy, and body, but Isaac got to tell us why he keeps trying.
I keep skating because it's a lot more kind of, you pace yourself. It's all about what you want to do. It doesn't really matter about a team or anything. And when I get hurt, it usually doesn't hurt for too bad or for too long. It's just too fun to let injuries get in the way.
For those of you who want to pick up skating, Isaac has some words of encouragement.
To someone who wanted to start skating, is a lot of people think it's super scary to go to the skate park when they first begin, which it is. However, no one really cares how good or bad you are as long as you just keep trying. And that's probably the best advice, just keep trying hard things.
So Knights, if you're looking for a fun pastime to take up this fall, maybe skating's for you. This is Lacey.
This is Ryan.
Reporting for the studio.
Well, Knights, that's all we have for you this week. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week with an all-new episode of The Studio. Yes, that's a wrap.
There you go.
Okay, literally, this is gonna be the craziest thing you've ever seen. Let's go. Let's roll. Okay.